Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Time Travel. Now today we're going to be taking a look at a program, or a program suite rather, called Windows Live OneCare. Yes, the video you're watching right now is over 4 years in the making, so I gotta give you a little backstory. In October of 2017, I attempted to take a look at my latest thrift store find, a copy of Windows Live OneCare, a $49.95 a year companion product for Windows that had a focus on security and performance, providing antivirus protection, system maintenance tools, and even file backup. Yes, this was a subscription service, because you can never have enough of those, right? And it was essentially Microsoft's way of competing with the likes of Norton and McAfee, which isn't really that difficult, while also adding a couple of other things. It came about after Microsoft purchased antivirus technology from a Romanian company called GCAD Software, which OneCare would be built on top of. And it eventually entered its beta development stages in August of 2005. Being in beta, Microsoft offered it for free to testers and even gave them the option to purchase 1 year of the final version of the service for 60% off, $19.95 instead of $49.95. And in the summer of 2006, it began selling for that full price. That's right, this actually predates Windows Vista, and the copy that I have here comes in the newer packaging that was changed after Vista was released. So that's great and all, but why was this video never published until now? Is this the Compact Portable Part 2 before the Compact Portable Part 2? Well, it actually was published, just over on my Extras channel. You see, when I put the disk into my computer and ran the setup wizard in a Windows Vista VM, it immediately came back and said that the installer could not connect to the activation servers, which have been down for years. So it's a dead end, right? Well, not exactly. Because after I published that video, I was contacted by somebody who thought they could reverse engineer the setup wizard to bypass that phase of the installation process. Long story short, they did, and OneCare Rewritten is the result, and that's what we're going to be talking about today. But first, I want to plug the person who made this whole thing. He goes by Cobs over on Twitter and Cobs Server Closet here on YouTube, and this is the tweet that he sent out when he initially was able to reverse engineer the installer and get OneCare installed, which is really, really awesome. This project has been out for a while, over a year in fact. I've been needing to get to this for a while, but better late than never, right? So there are a couple of caveats to this. Number one, and this is the biggest thing, you need to have a copy of OneCare. He's not providing the software itself, and it's understandable because he just wants to avoid any sort of copyright issues with Microsoft. In fact, he's even gone as far as to debrand the installer. The other big caveat is not everything is functional, and this is to be expected because just of the nature of what OneCare was, it relied on a lot of Microsoft services to be up and running that are now non-existent for all this stuff to work. So like online backup, for instance, doesn't work anymore because whatever Microsoft used for OneCare to backup files to doesn't exist anymore. Though he does mention that a patch in the future may be created to redirect the backup to OneDrive, which would be pretty cool actually. And that's pretty much the same deal for these three other components here. OneCare Circles is planned, printer sharing, which isn't really a big deal anyways because you can do that in Windows by default, it is planned. And Windows XP support sounds like it's going to be the most involving because it requires deep modifications to the installer that he's already made. But, you know, this is just a side project. Just want to throw that out there. This is not his full-time gig or anything. He said that this is just something he did on the side. So just please don't go, like, bugging him saying, when's XP support coming? So let's go ahead and switch to our Windows Vista virtual machine here and get this thing installed. But first, we have to install a couple of prerequisites. Number one is .NET 4.0. So I've already got that installed here. Number two is you need to have the Windows Live logon or the Windows Live ID sign-in system installed as well. So he actually provides this if we go back to the website here. If you go down here and go to, it's actually just up here at the top, you go to download now, he's got the OneCare Rewritten installer, which is both 32 and 64-bit compatible, and then you've got the 32-bit version of the Windows Live ID service and the 64-bit version of it. So we're in a 64-bit Windows Vista VM, so that's the version I've got here. So we'll accept that, install, and there we go. So we'll finish that. And now we can run the OneCare Rewritten Setup Wizard. So there's a few things to read over here. There's some frequently asked questions. And when you're ready, you go up here to the Install tab, and it says to make sure you have the OneCare disk in your optical drive. And we'll click on Install Now. And it will ask us to select our language. The only language is English UK at the moment, which is just fine for us. We're going to accept his terms and conditions, which is basically these notes here. He tells you, you know, do this at your own risk. This is not endorsed by Microsoft, all that stuff. And then here you have the actual Microsoft license agreement, so we'll accept that. And now it goes through its automated setup process. There's a lot of stuff that it does here. There's a system log window that opens up in the back here. So if it spit out any errors, you could see why it failed. But it's pretty much, in my testing, it installed just fine for me. Hopefully it will for you. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. So we'll just let it do its thing here. And when it opens up this command prompt window here, you're almost done because this is one of the last things that it has to do. You can see it's turned off Windows Defender because it's making OneCare the default antivirus software, which is something that I do not recommend and something that Cobb does not recommend either because, as you're going to see in a moment, you can't get any updated virus definition. So you're running on signatures from like 2006, which you definitely do not want to be doing. So you're going to want to swap your default antivirus program back to something that's actually modern. And there we go. So we've finished up. We can see it's installed here and it's just opened up OneCare, though the installer does say to not use OneCare until your computer has restarted, so it just opened it for us though. We're going to restart now and we'll click on finish. Now one of the first things OneCare will do is ask you to select a network location for your internet connection. We'll just make this a home network. And it'll do this a couple times there. And if we go down here, you can see we've got Windows Live OneCare running. Now, it immediately says that our status is at risk, and that's because, again, it cannot update our antivirus definitions. So they're super out of date, and that's why this is not meant to be used at all as a serious security product. That's not what this patch is intended to do. It's mainly just for the nostalgia factor, kind of just to take a look back at this program, see what it was all about, and get some functionality, even if it's just very minimal functionality, out of software that you own but can't use anymore because Microsoft shut down the activation server. So that's what this project is designed to do. But even though it can't update virus definitions, it can still scan for viruses. So we're gonna do a quick scan here. We're not gonna actually let it do the scan, but you know, it'll scan your computer for viruses. And if I had any viruses on here that were around in 2006, let's say, it would probably be able to detect them. Here's our really detailed scan report there. The other thing that's functional is the firewall, so there you go. Now the performance plus category is where the tune-up functionality lives, and this is something that will work at least partially. We can start it here. It'll give you a list of what it's going to do, so it's going to remove unnecessary files. Doesn't really exactly say what those are, and it's defragging the drive now, so that still works, but you can just do that in Windows by default. This is just kind of making it a little more automated in this like one-stop shop kind of thing. And of course, backup and restore ain't gonna work. You can click this all you want, not gonna do anything. We can go up here to about and view the version number and the virus and spyware definition version. There you go. Copyright 2007. So yeah, there it is. You've got these links up here. Let's see if these work. Windows Live OneCare help. No questions or answers about OneCare were found in your local help resources. Okay. Getting started with Windows Live OneCare. So that's what this first urgent pop-up here refers to. It's trying to connect to the OneCare servers to complete installation, but obviously it's not going to be able to do that. So that's also what this is asking you to do. And then you've got the privacy statement, which you also have to install, finish installing OneCare to do, and send feedback, same thing. So really the only other thing you can do from this screen is click on change settings over here, which brings up an XP control panel style interface here, where you can disable the firewall, you can configure the firewall, you can add, you know, exceptions, I'm sure. You can go to tune up here, you can choose to, you know, how often you want this to run. So there is a nice automated feature with that as well. Configure your backup settings, your virus and spyware if you want to turn that off, which we're going to do because it's pointless to have it on. Up here you got printer sharing, and you have logging right here, which we can create a support log if we want to. Let's see if this works. Not responding. Ooh, okay. Oh, there we go. Check that out. So this is actually a real support log. So it gives you information about your system here, machine name, all that stuff. Yeah, that's pretty neat. I wonder when the last time somebody generated one of these was. Well, I guess Cobs might have done it because, you know, he made the thing. He might have done it in his testing, right? But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much all there is to it, guys. That is Windows Live OneCare Rewritten. Like I said, certainly a really neat project, just not meant to be used seriously as a security solution. But I think it's always awesome when software gets brought back from the dead like this. And hopefully you guys think so too. So huge thank you to Cobs for putting in all the hard work that I'm sure was necessary to get this all up and running. And huge thanks to you guys for watching. As always, I will see you in the next video.